Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we are going to learn a concept which is known as Dividend Payout Ratio Formula. At the very first end, we are going to see the formula. Dividend Payout Ratio Formula shows something like this. You will have dividends which have been paid by the company divided by the net ratio. So let's understand this formula so that we'll have a clear understanding regarding this particular formula. Now, we are discussing dividend payout ratio formula over here. When a company, you can say, makes a profit at the end of the year, they may share a portion of their profit with the stockholders. We call it dividend, and by using the dividend payout ratio formula, we find out the percentage of the dividend paid to the shareholders. Basically, this has been paid out of the net profit of the company. Now, the formula, again, it goes something like this. Dividend payout ratio formula is equal to your dividend divided by net income. Let's understand this with the help of an example so that we'll have an understanding regarding the same. There's a company called Danny Inc. has been in the business for last few years. Recently, you know, it had started paying its shareholders dividend, and it has paid dividend of, let's say, $1,40,000. The net income of the company is, let's say, $4,20,000 in the last year. And Danny Inc. has decided to keep the retained earnings standing at 66.67. This is the retained earnings using the two methods. And find out, based on this, the dividend ratio for the last year for Danny Inc. Now, as mentioned in the whole example we discussed, we'll use two methods to calculate this ratio. First, we'll use the first ratio. This is the first ratio that we are going to go for. Now, we know that the dividend that has been paid in the last year, has been 1,40,000, right? And the net profit has been $4,20,000. So using the first ratio of the dividend payout ratio, the net income, which shows us as $4,20,000, using the first ratio of the dividend payout formula, we get something like this. The dividend ratio is equal to dividend divided by the net income. So let's divide dividend divided by the net income. So we get 0.33 as the answer for the same, which is 33.3%, right? So now we'll use the second ratio. Now we know that 66.67 was kept as retained earning because this has been paid, right? If we do 1 minus 33%, we'll get 67%. So 66.7% was kept as a retained earning. That means the retention ratio is standing at 66.67%. So now using the second method, we get dividend payout ratio is equal to 1 minus the retention ratio, 66.67%, which gives us 33.33%. So these are the two methods by which you can calculate. Now, let's apply dividend payout ratio calculation. I'll show you a practical example to understand dividend ratio in a much better fashion. Now, this is the data for the Apple's dividend payout ratio. A couple of details regarding dividend, net income, and the payout ratio. What you can see over here, right, from 2012 to 2016, from 2012 to 2013, there has been a major rise, and then it is significantly following the same with one reduction in 2015 and getting back in 2016. So you can say in just 1 year, there has been massive increase until 2011, Apple didn't pay any dividend to the investor because they believed that if they would reinvest the earnings, they'd be able to generate better returns for the investor, which they did eventually. So this is the case scenario for Apple. And look how they are changing their strategy by plowing back their money into their business and reinvesting for research purpose, for expanding the infrastructure, and so on and so forth. Now, after understanding the formula with the help of a real life example, let's understand the explanation part of the dividend payout ratio. Now, for a company, sharing the profit is afterthought. First, they decide how much they will reinvest into the company so that the business can grow bigger and the business can multiply the shareholders' money instead of just sharing it. So that's why the dividend payout ratio formula is vital for any company. It tells how much a company is paying dividend to its shareholders and how much the company is reinvesting into itself, which we called as the retained earnings, right? So sometimes, you know, a company does not pay attention or pay anything to their shareholders because they feel that they need to reinvest their profits of the company so that the company grow faster. Now, since the net profit of the company are only used over here, what we use as the net profit of the company, we can conclude that the net income is equal to your retained earnings plus any dividend that has been paid, right? So this is going to be the formula. Now, this is the graph of Amazon, if you see Google, Alphabet, Berkshire Hathaway and Colgate. Now, in case of Amazon, Google and Berkshire Hathaway, 0% dividend payout. There's no dividend they are paying it. But in case of Colgate, they are paying 61.78%. Now, what we know that Colgate is really paying high dividend, 61.67%, that is in 2016 and 17. And rest three are just 0%. They haven't paid a penny to the shareholders via the dividends. Now, if an investor looks at the income statement of the company, he or she would be able to find the net income for the year. And in the balance sheet, they can find the retained earnings of what that would be found. So if you need to know how the company has calculated the retained earnings and also the dividends, you can check the footnotes under the financial statement. Now, what is exactly the use? I want to understand what is exactly the use of this dividend payout ratio. See, understanding the equation between the retained earnings and the dividend payment will help an investor comprehend the short term, and the dividend payment will help the investor comprehend the short term and the long term goal of the company. Now, since many companies also pay 100% dividend, we can also use an alternative formula for calculating the dividend payout ratio. Now, the alternative method will be dividend payout ratio basically is equal to 1 minus your retention ratio. Now, retention ratio is basically the percentage of the profit the company keeps for reinvestment. Now, looking at the past dividend payout ratio formula, the investor gets insured about how much they may receive in the near future. So, the dividend payout ratio is really very important because it is a great measure for driving the valuation of the company, where Gordon's growth model has been used for the calculation of the market price per share. So it is a very big driver.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.